Often when we consider x-rays, we think of broken bones or teeth. This is because they are dense tissues and show up well on x-ray. Soft tissues do not absorb x-rays, and so the signal is far less attenuated. Even more importantly, we cannot differentiate between the different types of soft tissue. If we could introduce something dense, this will absorb the x-rays. Metals are dense and so opaque to x-rays, and so they can be used to add contrast to the image. Barium is one such metal. It has an atomic mass of 56 and so is very dense compared to tissue. Because the problem is that barium ions in solution are highly toxic and very reactive. However, if we use barium sulphate, this is extremely insoluble in water, so there are no free ions and it is a powder. This powder can be given as a slurry in the water, which can be swallowed. The density of this mixture can achieve 4.5 grams per milliliter. The radiographer then takes a series of images using a technique called fluoroscopy. This is done as the patient drinks or swallows the slurry. Here is an x-ray before starting. Can you pick the esophagus in this image? What about now? You can easily see the esophagus as the slurry passes to the stomach. If there was a partial obstruction in the esophagus or a leak, it could be very easy to see. So in summary, the barium absorbs the x-rays. This means that the signal is attenuated, so the image appears dark. Hopefully you can now see how we can combine the different concepts to build up a procedure that can provide the information that the doctor needs.